I need to reiterate that those were just the basics. There are a lot of complications that we're going to address now. First of all, in the previous example, we should think about the for loop. Does the for loop itself count for something? In order for the loop to work, you need to do a computation each time to get the next letter in the string. Since this needs to happen one time for every input letter, we can just add 1 to the value before n, and now we end up with 3n plus 2. It turns out that it's actually really hard to predict how many computations this pseudocode is going to take. For example, a lower-level language like C would break down the process a lot more, and it would take a lot more lines of code, but they would be doing less work in the background. The Python version of this might be about this many lines of code, but it would be doing a lot more in the background because it's a higher-level language. For example, let's look at this line. This line could take a different number of computations based on the data structure the cipher is using. Maybe we store our data in a list, and we need to check each letter against our current letter to solve the code. That could be as many as 26 checks for each letter in our input string. So ultimately, our efficiency calculation might look a little more like this. Let's go back to those example input strings we talked about before. Now, if we start out with a 10-letter input string, we end up with 292 computations. If we start out with 1 million letters in our input string, we end up with 29 million steps to go through. Because of our choice of data structure, we're doing a lot more computations than we might if we chose it a little bit smarter. Later, we'll talk a little bit more about the efficiency of different types of data structures, but for now, hopefully you realize the importance of thinking about efficiency before writing code.